going to show you guys a quick clip, because this clip is going to really clarify what this entire video is about a little bit better than any words I could say ever could.
You know what I'm saying?
Buttons, do you understand that the things you did don't just affect you? They damaged my reputation, too. I stood up for you for so long, and then to find out that, oh no, yeah, I was full of shit, and I'm not going to apologize to anyone I affected because of it. I'm just going to pretend like none of it happened. Do you know how that made me feel?
I wasn't full of shit. I actually believed the thought I was believing until I actually talked to FNGR and realized I made mistakes. That's not the same as lying.
That's the point. You never apologized for how your mistakes affected me or Leo or Vita. All of us are still dealing with the consequences.
Well, I'm not apologizing to DeVita. I'm not apologizing to him because he's been trying to get me to put into a fucking mental hospital.
Because you belong there! Because you have severe mental illnesses, including multiple personalities, that need to be treated, and you are refusing to take care of yourself. You are an unstable individual.
Actually, they're pursuing that right now. Who left?
I hung up the call because she said that. End the stream right now, please.
Don't you fucking kick me from this call.
Okay.
But if there's an issue, it might be better to deal with it at a later date.
Yeah, Buttons, you could take a walk. It's okay. We could talk later.
No. You do not say my personal shit on stream.
I didn't.
You do not fucking say that. No, I'm talking to Patchwork.
Oh, okay.
They didn't need to fucking know that.
Did I get kicked from the call, or did I just accidentally?
We both got kicked.
Please delete the stream. Please shut it off.
What?
Delete the stream. Take out that part.
What are you talking
Shut
about?
Shut it off. She said I have multiple personality.
I mean, Step's already in the
stream. Shut the stream off.
Everyone who already is going to talk about it, there's like 5 or 6 barrel people. It's not going to disappear. If you think that somebody doesn't have OBS opening and is recording at any given time, if I delete it, they're just going to rehost it on Fusion's channel.
Now, did you catch what happened there? Buttons lost control of the entire room, live, on stream, and then decided that she was going to start kicking people out and take it hostage. This is going to be a very consistent theme as we go forward. Silence. Now, I'd also like you to remember, Buttons was the one who insisted on being there. Buttons was the one who insisted that they had the right to defend themselves. Buttons was there by Buttons' accord. And Buttons decided, the second that they were no longer in control of the situation, to start fucking freaking out and taking the room hostage. That, as well, is going to be a very common theme. Buttons forcing themselves into a situation, and it going horribly wrong. Now, with a hot, fresh introduction for you and a frame of reference, why don't we move right to the epicenter, the ground zero, so that we can see exactly where everything fell apart. Now, many of you who watch my channel may already be aware of this situation, but for those who don't, I'll sum it up for you. Buttons, and for no good reason, had a falling out near the end of July. The reason why is that, well, Buttons had sent, for no good reason, at some point, a quote-unquote lewd image that she believed he was going to leak. Now, the operative word here is believed. Now, she actually reached out to LioConvoy, and she had a conversation with him to ask him, to ask Anthony, I gave a telephone here, mind you, to delete that image. Anthony, for no good reason, had stated that he no longer possessed this image, and that he was not going to leak it even if he found it. He had no idea, mind you, based on his own admission, if it was still on his computer or not, but he had no idea where it was, what it was named. It may as well have been lost in the ether. Now, what would the natural thing to do be? Well, this is Buttons we're talking about, so the natural thing to do is do some mental gymnastics and make it seem like everybody's out to get you, including Anthony, and every single person who doesn't immediately say, "You're right!" Buttons reached out to many people to get assurances that she was not crazy and that she was right to be afraid that Anthony would leak her lewd image. Well, I was one such person who had that conversation with her, and I assure you, she was absolutely fucking bonkers. Now, I'll show you that conversation in full here on the screen. I'm not going to take the time to read that out for you, but I will be showing it here so that you can pause and read it for yourself. Now, directly following this conversation, I actually reached out to LioConvoy to get verification of what Buttons had said, that Anthony had stated he deleted it, so that I could have a better frame of reference of what exactly transpired in their conversation. Naturally, LioConvoy told me the truth, as they typically do. LioConvoy had told me that Anthony had never used the word deleted, and that Lio himself had never used the word deleted, as was claimed. Rather, Anthony had stated that he did not know where it was or what it was named, and that he was not going to leak it, and that Lio had repeated to Buttons that, quote, it was handled. The words, he has deleted it, never left his mouth, nor did Anthony claim, I have deleted it. Now, this would be no harm, no foul if Buttons had accepted. I must have misinterpreted things. I must have looked into something that wasn't really there, and everything had dissipated. But naturally, since you're here watching this video, that's not what happened. Instead, Buttons took this to mean they're changing the story. They're conspiring against me. They're doing some 4D fucking chess, some massive fucking gay ops to try and bring me down. Well, later that day, there was actually a stream to discuss this subject. I'll be linking that in the description. It is a fucking ride.
Hello, yes, I am LioConvoy. I am a big, mean bully, and I am here to tell you the tale of Fable Tale the Stupid. During the live stream where Anthony tried to confront Buttons about selling nudes to Kiwi Farms, right after Buttons tried to accuse Anthony of threatening to leak their nudes, I got pulled into a group chat with Buttons, Fable Tale, and a few others. I was at work and didn't want to get roped into this nonsense, so I told them to figure it out amongst themselves like adults and then took my leave. I was then messaged by Fable Tale doing her best I'm in an anime impression by claiming that she'd protect Buttons at any cost. I flatly told her that she can't even manage to protect herself. I also told her if Anthony did leak the news, he'd have to deal with me. I followed that up by telling Fable she needs to ask Buttons about trying to sell someone else's nudes to Kiwi Farms. At that point, she decided to double down in her stupidity. So I decided to prove the point that she couldn't even protect herself by informing her that Barrel members had found out where she lived a while ago. Her response was demanding that I prove it by telling her what her real name was. She then blocked me before I could respond, because that's what a confident person that's not afraid does, right? Run away? So I went into the chat of Anthony's still ongoing live stream and typed in her name. And wouldn't you know it, but she starts messaging me on Skype, trying to claim that's not her real name. I pointed out that literally all of her personal information is easily found on Facebook because she's a big dummy, you big dumb idiot. She also may have reported my posts on Twitter about all of this as well, leading to a suspension. Because that's the best thing to do to a guy that constantly puts himself out there to stop pedophiles and protect kids. Get him suspended by abusing the report system because you made a fool of yourself. You absolute goon. After that, things got a bit quiet. Until Buttons and Plushy got into it again. And Plushy decided to make a Discord server to end their feud. Someone went into said server posing as Buttons, and Fable went in as well. This is where the Buttons faker literally tried to extort Plushy for money. And what did Fable do when she saw this? Did her moral ideals finally crawl their way out of the stupidity layers of her brain? No, she immediately backed the impersonator and tried to extort Plushy as well. She'll tell you she was just playing along to find out who the impersonator was, but that's really not any better. That's like catching someone breaking into someone's home and joining in just to tell the cops later that you were just playing along the whole time. Speaking of cops, though, Plushy brought all of this to Barrel, informing us what happened. So I looked into it, passed the info on to Josh Scorcher, and information of Fable's misdeed was spread. I also got Plushy to file a police report about it, giving the info needed to do that. Anthony tried to reach Fable to get her to explain herself, making it very clear I had her info to file the police report with. Fable, being totally not sharp as a bowling ball, decided the best thing to do was to play pretend that she was going to report me to the police for doxing. Fable. Honey. Darling. Bad Inuyasha screen cap recolorer. I didn't actually dox you. I used the very public information you put on your Facebook to find your listing in the literal white pages. A very legal resource. Even if you were to try to file a report about it, you'd be laughed at. And furthermore, it's not like I spread it. I gave it to Plushy solely for the purpose of filing the report. It has not been posted publicly anywhere. Speaking of Plushy, It was after this that Fable simultaneously stated publicly that she didn't do wrong, while privately begging Plushy to drop the whole thing, going so far as to tell him, "You're putting my family in danger." No, Fable. No, Fable. Even if these actions did put your family in danger, which they don't, the blame would be on you for instigating this. Let me be crystal clear here, for those who aren't paying attention. It is not a victim's fault that you were dumb enough to be controlled by your baser instincts and tried to prey upon them. Ever. Under any circumstances. It is never the victim's fault. After that, she tried to threaten me to dropping this via threats of litigation that probably would have scared a brony. Too bad I'm not a brony then, because my response was to give her my information, my address, and ultimately say, "Do it, pussy." Realizing her asinine tactic wasn't going to work on me, she blocked me. Only to unblock me and message me again not too long afterwards, trying the same tactic again. Yes, people, she is literally that stupid. Cut to not too long after that, and Grizzly the Medic, a BronyCon security member exposed as a sexual predator of children, becomes an important topic. Nighteye posted my short warning video on Fable's server to spread awareness. And Fable's response, of course, was to tell him to not post stuff like that because Vita Man bad. Because when a predator is exposed, whether or not you like the person doing the exposing is what matters, right? Right? Do I have anything I personally want to apologize for after all this? Actually, I do. In the logs, I called Fable a stuttering imbecile. Her stutter isn't something she can help, and that was uncalled for. I shouldn't mock her for something she can't help, and for that, I am genuinely sorry. Instead, I should just mock her for her bad art and poor decisions. Get bent, Fable. This isn't the first time she's done something this dumb either. She did some asinine stream about standing up to bullying a while ago, wherein she overtly stated that if Vita came to BronyCon, that her boyfriend would beat him up. I would love to show you this clip, but this brave, brave soldier of anti-bullying removed it because she was scared.
Oh, did you take it down because you're scared of the little bullies? No, I'm not fucking scared.
I'm not going to pretend that Vita is a super jacked MMA master. I mean, he could be, though, and should be. Get to lifting, big boy. But your boyfriend looks like two trash bags strung together. I saw him at BronyCon, and if that's what you consider intimidating, well, it's starting to make sense why you're such a coward. Go back to your bad vampire role-playing, your stupid over-coloring of Inuyasha screen caps, and never, ever breed. You know what I want right now? Some Five Guys burgers and fries. Gee, wonder why I'd want that. Any idea, Fable? Maybe, just maybe, just maybe. If you want to talk about protecting other people, you shouldn't put your personal information out in the public, including where you work, you big dumb idiot.
And naturally, after the accusations started flying towards Anthony, especially when most of them, again, were not founded by anything that exists within the confines of reality, many of Button's friends decided they didn't really want much to do with Buttons anymore, myself included. Also, it did include an individual that we're going to talk about now, SpokenMind93. Now, SpokenMind did make a video about this subject, and I'll be linking that in the description. But that's not what I want to talk about in this particular segment. What I want to talk about is how Buttons reacted to this video, which was to false flag it and try to incite everyone who followed her on Twitter to false flag it as well.
Hey everyone, I'm SpokenMind. Coyote Lovely here asked me if I wanted to do a segment for his video on Buttons, and damn right I wanted to. After I made my video, I got a person responsible for my suspension. Fable Tale. Thanks for throwing your friend under the bus there, Buttons. Just a reminder that this isn't the first time they threw Fable under the bus, and another reminder that Fable had absolutely no problem being a double agent the last time the Buttons drama happened. But either they have a badass memory, or they have some sort of bipolar disorder. Both of them. That makes them switch moods faster than a cheetah can run. And the reason she reported me? Because I apparently set their quote-unquote legal name in my tweets. First of all, it was someone else that mentioned your real and full name, Fable. Second, I only mentioned a first fake name, and believe it or not, from only that name, there are about 400,000 running around in the United States alone. Same with that other name, there are a lot of those running around. Which brings me to the big point I wanted to talk about in this. The ridiculousness of doxing. Don't know if Coyote has or hasn't yet talked about it, so if I repeat some points you're making or gonna make, my apologies. Doxing has been made such a nightmarish concept these last few years, it's beyond ridiculous. And it's only been made worse with creation of social media and the fact these sites ask you for all the information and the more personal the better. Now, smart people would put fake names, fake numbers, fake emails, what have you, but some people, particularly young people, don't think about that and then are faced with the fact that their full and legal name is out there years later and it takes a simple Google search for somebody to find out. Believe it or not, and I know some people have already found out, I made a Twitter account years back with my full legal name and I still regret that to this day. And then you have the dumb people who are going all, "My information is private, you really have to go digging to find it," when it's literally just there, and you find out that they made some account with their legal name when they were 20 years old, and very easy to find, just by a simple Google image search. Or you're thinking that you made your Facebook private, but it's very much public, and you were so stupid that you literally put your fictional nickname so you're easy to find and your personal friends can comment and call you by your real name. This ain't rocket science. I know this may be a foreign concept for this generation, but there's such a thing called the white pages. Before the time of Google, that's how you found people, and guess what? All your information was in there. So if you want to go claim doxing charges to someone, better go and do that for the white pages too. The only reason I edited my video was because I wanted to play it safe in terms of YouTube. The original video is still very much out there and linked in the re-uploaded video's description. And it's still up and running even though Buttons tried to mass flag it. Okay, so let's see what else I can ramble about in terms of the great and powerful Buttons. No, wait, the meek and pathetic Buttons. Trixie at least learned some humility when faced with her mistakes. Because that's the thing with them. They never learn, and they will never learn from their mistakes because they keep making them time and time again. They literally cannot stay away from drama as much as they want to claim they aren't. Hell, just the other day when Fable was caught extorting Matt Plushy, asking $300 from him or she would call the cops, but it was definitely to catch someone in a lie, and that makes it totally better. Buttons was advised by Leo to sit this one out. And wouldn't you know it, FNGR makes a stream, and guess who didn't sit this one out, and actually came on stream to defend someone. They just said they were done defending and sitting that one out. Yeah. Buttons never keeps to their word, and I'm gonna reiterate my message from my video. Don't give them a finger because they will take your whole torso. They will drain your mental health and they wouldn't even care because Buttons, Buttons, Buttons is the most important one. It's best if you stay as far away from them as you possibly can. Alright, I think that's the best I could make for Coyote's video. Thanks for including me. Back to you.
Now, there's a little bit of a lemony twist to this Pepsi of retardation, to this new generation of fucking autism. That twist being, Buttons had previously complained about somebody doing the exact same shit to them back in the Drakenator situation. Let's roll clip.
After the Google Doc was posted, FNGR offered to stream with Andrew about all of this, and we agreed I wouldn't be going along in case it caused issues and Coyote Lovely would be the one to be the mouthpiece for Andrew, as he didn't want to reveal his voice, even though he already made a video, you know, calling for my video to be false flagged using his voice, but whatever.
It's happening. That's it. All I ask is that you please go report the video in the channel, which will be linked below. Thank you.
What the fuck even at all, Buttons? So you're going to previously establish that false flagging is wrong, and then go and false flag somebody who was your friend, but is no longer your friend because of your own fucking retardation. You're going to false flag them because you can't handle it? Are you fucking serious? Are you broken? Well, unfortunately for Spoken Mind, this little gay op happened to work, and she had to completely remove her video, alter it, and then re-upload it and hope for the best. I say hope because Buttons did successfully false flag that video into being taken down. But hold on to your hats, folks, because we have not yet hit the totality of everything that is to occur. We have not yet hit critical mass. A little ways down the road, Buttons decided that this was not good enough. They weren't going to just take an L and walk away. Buttons decided that they were going to try to get creators to start smearing for no good reason. And she was not content to get any cut-rate ranter. She actually went to try to super chat Mr. Medicare so that he would make a second video on For No Good Reason. Not only that, she went into DMs on Twitter and began lying to Tipster to try to convince him to make a video as well. Let's roll clip.
You did not hear this from me, but who the fuck is Buttons Locked? She showed up on my Twitch chat last night making a bunch of claims about you, and now she's spamming my Twitter DMs.
Yep, she's my crazy ex-mang. If you have any questions, any, by all means. I was at work, so if I say anything completely off here.
Said you were stalking her and threatening to leak her nudes, yet she didn't provide any proof to back her claims.
So, when I was in the hospital, when we weren't dating anymore, she sent me a nude. After she stopped talking to me, she demanded I delete it. I couldn't find it for a couple of days. She's been told by several reasonable, logical people when I said, if your nudes get out, it won't be my fault because she's a careless dumbass, and she is.
But you did eventually delete them.
I do like to point out that she's the person who tried selling Lulu Kitty's nudes to Kiwi Farms. Yes, Mang. I done have her nudes now. She kept insisting I legally had to, which I'm pretty sure is bullshit. I'm well aware revenge porn is illegal.
What about the stalking? Any truth to that?
I go how pray tell.
Question mark, question mark, a question mark.
I continue on here. If she shit-talks me, I respond. Hi, by the way, that's me doing this now. I've been accused of rape and abuse, etc., etc.
She accused you of rape? For real? WTF.
Yeah.
This bitch is crazy, alright? I'm just going to ignore her dumbass, lol.
Oh, dick's out for Button's integrity. Sorry, I'm getting so fucking tired of this topic that I'm trying to amuse myself. Now that looks pretty goddamn bad, doesn't it? Trying to get bigger YouTubers to attack somebody just because you had a falling out with them. Well, it's about to look even worse. Now we're gonna hold up real quick, because it's rewind time. You remember, if you follow my Twitter, about a month back, I had tweeted out saying that there was a delay on the video, and it was for a very good reason, and that you would have to trust me for now. Well, I'm about to talk to you about what that reason was. I had put a delay on the video because Buttons had served Anthony paperwork to try to get a restraining order on him for stalking her. can you hear the fucking comical part of that? He's stalking her right now. He's stalking her. That fucking fits. Now, in the realm of garden variety crazy, that's to be expected. But what had me completely fucking floored was what happened just a few days ago in the aftermath of her attempt to do that. What had me floored was that after she attempted to make it legally impossible for Anthony to defend himself in this sort of situation, she still reached out to a much bigger YouTuber to try to smear him and drag his fucking name through the goddamn mud. Now, I was not at the court hearing. I can't say for sure how the ruling came out, and whether or not Anthony does have a restraining order and cannot or can defend himself. What I do know is there was an attempt. There was an attempt to abuse the legal system to silence him permanently on this subject, and afterwards there was still an attempt to reach out to a much bigger creator now that he cannot defend himself, potentially, mind you. I don't know for sure because we can't get a clear answer. But there is still attempts to drag his name through the mud. I'm going to show a screenshot that will only verify that this conversation happened, because I don't know how this person feels about me leaking the entire conversation, but I do think that it does need to be verified that this conversation existed. Unfortunately, it is a better ask forgiveness than ask permission situation. Buttons had evidently reached out to Nani with this information. What I can only imagine is the same story they fed Tipster. The story that Anthony clarified was nothing but chatting shit. Well, Anthony can't clarify that now, can he? I mean, potentially, anyway. We don't know whether or not there was a restraining order. We don't know whether or not he can speak on this subject anymore. He's not being clear about it, and neither is Buttons. What we do know is that if it turned out that way, she's still trying to fucking ruin him the same way now that he can't legally defend himself. And that right there has got to be one of the most corrupt fucking things I've heard in my entire life, if it's true. Again, I don't have anything to support that this restraining order did come into effect, but what I do know, there was an attempt. All of these things have been shown to you with a purpose, to help you understand one thing, if you are a friend of Buttons. When the other shoe drops, not if, when you have a falling out with Buttons, when you stop believing their bullshit, because that's what it is, fucking bullshit, don't expect to have a voice to speak with if they have their say. Expect them to attempt to suspend your Twitter account, to flag your videos, to take you to court, to force you to be silent. Don't ever trust this person, because if you do, when the other shoe drops, there's only going to be one thing coming from you when she's trying to drag your name through the mud. Now, there is just a bevy of other things to talk about in this situation regarding Buttons, but for the most part, a lot of it has already been said. I only wanted to focus on recent events that needed to be given a voice, because quite frankly, the last thing she deserves is silence from anyone else. That's going to finish up this video. The links to the artist to do my character stills are in the pinned comment, as well as the description, as well as the artist who has done the art that I use on my thumbnails. There are links to my social media as well in the description, and I will catch you guys in the next video.